Hey everyone, welcome back to Daily Tuition. In this video, I will show you how to create a sidebar with animated hamburger menu. In this sidebar, we will add website name, navigation item, and social links. Along with that, we will animate hamburger menu. So when you click on the hamburger menu, you will see this sidebar. You can see this sidebar is responsive for mobile devices also. We are using CSS for styling HTML and also use JavaScript to add click event to the hamburger menu. So before we start this video, make sure you press the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get notified of my every new video, and also like this video if you find anything useful. So before we getting late, let's get started. First, you need to open empty folder in editor and create two files in that folder, index.html and style.css. In index.html file, create simple HTML5 snippets and specify title. I will split this window so you will know what is going on. After that, we link two files. First one is font awesome CSS file to use icons in the project. And second, it's style.css. In the body tag, create a container class. And in that class, put a navigation with navbar class and specify id, nav id. In the navigation, create a button of type button and specify a class toggle collapse and id toggle button. In this button, create a span tag and specify class toggle icon. Using this class, we create hamburger menu. Now we will create a navigation. So we will add an order list here with site nav class. And here we put a li tag with nav item class. In the li tag, we insert anchor tag and specify site name class. So here we first specify our website name. After that, we create second navigation item with nav item class and insert anchor tag with nav link class. So here we first specify first navigation item home. After that, we insert another li tag with nav item class and create anchor tag with nav link class, and then specify block text. I will fast forward this video and create features, pricing, and contact us navigation item. I will use same classes to create this navigation item. On the last navigation item, we insert social icon using font awesome website. So I will add some social icons here like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. Now the time is style this HTML. In style.css file, select body tag and remove margin and padding from the HTML element, and we will specify font family and background color to the body element. Then I will create navbar class and specify position, absolute, right, 0 pixel, width, 260 pixel. You are free to choose your own navigation width, so you can change this value. Specify height, 100%, background color, black, text align, center, and transition property 0.8 second is. Then I will select side nav class, which is child of navbar class. And specify list style type none, padding 0 and margin 0. Create a nav item class and specify display flex. Then select the child element of navigation item, which is nav link, and specify text decoration none. Color, font size 1.1 em, padding 1 em, and flex 1. We specify flex 1 property to fill the remaining space of the navigation item. After that, create hover effect on the navigation link. And specify background color and color property. Now we will align this toggle menu on the left side of the sidebar and create toggle collapse class. And specify float property left, margin left, so it will align to the left side of the sidebar. Margin top 0.5 em, content blank, outline inherit, border 0 pixel, and background transparent. Now we will create toggle button. So using toggle icon class, I will create toggle button. In the previous video, I showed you how to create toggle icon with animation. We are creating the same code here also. So you can skip this section if you already watched the previous video. If not, if you wanted to watch the previous video, you can watch this video from the top right corner of the screen. In the toggle icon code, I just made some changes and specify different width for horizontal bars of toggle icon. After creating the toggle icon, we select site name class and specify text decoration none, padding 1.3 em, font size 2 em, and color white smoke. Select the social icon using nav item last child and specify padding 0.5 em. Then create hover effect for the social icons. And specify background color black and color property white. Now we will going to create JavaScript section. Before closing body tag, create a script tag and here insert function and call this function as my function and specify parameter e. Before we create this function, we specify this function on the button on click event. So I will write the code for the button here on click and specify function name, and in the function parameter we specify this keyword. In this function I will write e dot class list dot toggle method, and in the toggle method parameter I will specify show class. Show class is created when creating a toggle icon. In this class we just increase the width of the toggle icon bars. So this will look like this. After that we create a variable called element and specify document.getElementById. Specify the parameter id of the navigation, which is nav id. Then we get the style applied to the element. Create write variable and get the value of write property in the write variable. After that we create if and else statement, and we create a condition where if write property is equal to 0 pixel then execute if statement, otherwise execute else statement. In the if statement, first select the navigation using element variable and specify write property minus 260 pixel. So 260 pixel is the width of your navigation. If you specify different value for your navigation width, then your value will be different. In the else statement, specify write property 0 pixel. If you notice, in style.css file, we specify write property 0 pixel to the navbar class. In the if statement, we are just changing the write property value of navbar class. That's it. Your sidebar navigation menu is ready. You can create different type of navigation menu with different animation. Practice with this tutorial and make some changes in the sidebar and see what happened. This sidebar is responsive for mobile devices. That is all for this tutorial. Before you go to the next video, press like button if you find anything useful, and also press the subscribe button to get notified of my every new video. If you have any question, then you can ask me in the comment section. That is all for now. We will see you in the next lecture. Till then, be happy and keep watching.